You had a pretty good season last year with a lot of sophomores playing on your team. You had a record of 9-13, and everybody's up a year now, and you've got some good sophomores coming in and a lot of the regulars back. What do the prospects for this year's baseball team look like?
Well, we think we're going to be improved. As you said, we used 5 starters last year as sophomores, and it was our worst record in the last 9 years, and we weren't very proud of it, but we got a lot of experience, and we expect to have a better ball club this year.
What do you think are your strong points?
Well, I think our pitching depth is our strong point. We've got 5 or 6 pitchers right now that look real good to me.
Your leader, of course, is Ed Sherry. He had a record of 7-1 last year.
That's right. He's a fine pitcher and a fine hitter.
What about batting now? What's that look like?
Well, it's going to have to be improved this year over last year. We had a .270 team batting average last year, which isn't bad, but it was all tied up in about 2 or 3 kids, you know, and Sherry and Roddebush and Putnam, and this year we're going to have better hitting overall as a team.
Is there any, besides Sherry, can you single out some players who are looking up and we can count on this year?
Well, Bradford is back at third, and we've moved John McCoy over from second to shortstop, and we've moved a young kid by the name of Nino Muffaletto in at second base, and Mike Pianowski's back in all-conference first baseman. Mike Putnam was second-team all-conference at catcher, and in the outfield, of course, Roddebush had a great year last year, hit .348, and Jim Nova, the young sophomore kid from Flint, Michigan, I think is one of the finest ball players we've had here since Mervin Redeman.
Yeah, of course, people remember him in the football season. I didn't realize he played baseball, too.
Yeah, he's a fine baseball.